Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. This is module number 2, first law of thermodynamics, and this is lecture number 206, second module, sixth lecture. And we recap from the previous lectures. So, in the previous lectures, again in the first law of thermodynamics, we applied the first law of thermodynamics to the open system and we derived the steady flow energy equation. Using the steady flow energy equation, we solved problems on various mechanical engineering devices. And the topic for this lecture is application of first law of thermodynamics to the closed system. And by applying the first law of thermodynamics to the closed system, we find out, we discuss various thermodynamic processes. And the learning outcome for the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to derive the work done, heat transfer, change in internal energy and change in enthalpy for various thermodynamic processes. And these are all the thermodynamic processes that we are going to discuss. Number 1, isochoric or constant volume process. Number 2, isobaric or constant pressure process. Number 3, isothermal process or constant temperature process. 4, adiabatic process. 5, polytropic process. And 6, free expansion process. And the first 5 processes are very important from engineering perspective. So, in the future courses also, we will be discussing, we will be using the first 5 processes. We take the first process, isochoric or constant volume process. The volume of the system, thermodynamic system, is kept constant. There is no change in the volume. And you look at the arrangement, we have a vessel filled with gas. The initial pressure of the gas is measured as P1 and the volume remains constant. Now, we are adding heat energy and we record the temperature and pressure. We measure the temperature and pressure of the gas using the appropriate instruments and we plot the pressure volume diagram. And when you measure the pressure here, there is no possibility of increasing volume or change in the volume. So, the piston is fixed here. So, the pressure of the gas is continuously increasing and this is what the increase in pressure. So, the increase when you add the heat energy, the pressure increases and the volume remains constant. And the work done during the constant volume process. So, for thermodynamics, the work done is PdV work, integral PdV. There is no change in the volume, dV equal to 0. So, work done during the constant volume process is equal to 0. And the first law of thermodynamics can be written as Q12 equal to W12 plus delta U. So, W12 from the previous discussion, W12 equal to 0. So, Q12 equal to U2 minus U1, which is MCV into T2 minus T1 for the perfect gases. So, from the equation, we find that when you add the heat energy, the internal energy will increase and when you remove the heat energy, internal energy will decrease. So, that is what the statement here. Heat addition will increase the internal energy of the gas and similarly, the heat rejection will decrease the internal energy of the gas. For unit mass of the gas, in specific internal energy. For unit mass, the change in the specific internal energy. So, dividing the previous equation by mass. So, dividing the previous equation by mass, this will become delta small u equal to Cv into T2 minus T1. And change in enthalpy, delta H equal to MCP into T2 minus T1. And similarly, for unit mass, the change in specific enthalpy, this is given by delta H equal to Cp into T2 by T1. And relation between pressure and temperature. So, the volume is constant from the perfect gas equation. we may write P1 by P2 equal to P1 by P2. That is how the pressure and temperatures are changing. And the second process is isobaric process or constant pressure process. And here again, we assume the piston cylinder arrangement with a movable piston. And we have the initial, this is the initial position of the gas. So, the piston is at this position. We have the gas, we measure the pressure of the gas and we measure the volume of the gas. The pressure is P1, volume is V1. We plot the pressure volume in the PV diagram. Now, the heat is added. Heat is added to the gas, heat is supplied to the gas. So, to maintain the pressure as a constant, the piston is reciprocating. So, piston is moving in the upward direction. And after some amount of heat addition, this is the final position of the piston. And we draw the diagram, constant pressure diagram. So, pressure remains constant. So, we will get a horizontal line in the PV plot. So, this is what the final condition. Now, here the work done. Work done for the constant pressure process, it is area under the PV diagram. So, this is a rectangle. How to calculate the area of the PV diagram? So, the change in the volume V2 minus V1 into the height, that is the height is equal to the pressure. So, it is simply, we can even integrate. So, W12 equal to integral PdV. So, P is a constant. So, take it out of the integral. Differentiating dV with respect, differentiating dV and substitute the limit. That will be V2 minus V1. So, the work done during this process is P into V2 minus V1. And from first law of thermodynamics, so heat transfer Q equal to W plus delta U. So, W12 plus delta U. So, we write the W12. W12 equal to pressure into V2 minus V1 plus U2 minus U1. Pressure P can be substituted as P2 or P1. P1 equal to P2. So, P2 V2 minus P1 V1. Plus U2 minus U1, club the parameter, so P2 V2 plus U2 minus of P1 V1 plus U1, so this P2 V2 plus U2 is the H2 and P1 V1 plus U1 equal to H1, that is enthalpy. So, the internal energy and the flow work that gives the enthalpy. So, the heat transfer Q equal to H2 minus H1. So, the heat transfer here, it will increase the change the enthalpy of the gas. So, which is equal to mCp into delta T. So, for all the thermodynamic process, enthalpy is, change in enthalpy is mCp into T2 minus T1. For unit mass, the change in specific enthalpy, so dividing the previous equation by mass, so delta H is delta small h equal to Cp into T2 minus T1. And here you observe, when you add the heat energy, the enthalpy will increase. And similarly, when you reject the heat energy, the enthalpy of the gas will decrease. That is what the conclusion for the process, for the particular process. So, in the constant volume process, heat addition will change the internal energy of the gas. In the constant pressure process, the heat addition will change the enthalpy of the gas. That is the difference you have to understand. And change in internal energy, the equation is going to be the same. Delta U equal to U2 minus U1, that is M into Cv into T2 minus T1. And for unit mass, the change in internal energy is delta U, delta small u equal to Cv into T2 minus T1. So, the previous equation, we divide by the mass. And relation between volume and temperature. So, here pressure is constant. So, from the perfect gas equation, relation between volume and temperature, V1 by V2 equal to T1 by T2. And isothermal of constant temperature process. So, for perfect gas, the gas equation PV equal to MRT, that is the perfect gas equation. Now, P is the pressure, V is the volume, M is the mass of the gas, R is the gas constant and T is the temperature. For constant temperature process, look at the right hand side, M is constant because it is a closed system, R is constant, it is property of the gas and T is the temperature is constant for this particular process. So, for constant temperature process, the PV, the product of PV equal to constant during the process. So, for isothermal or constant temperature process, the condition for the process is the PV equal to constant, the product of pressure and volume is constant. And this is what the diagram, PV diagram and the arrangement for the constant temperature process. And we have a piston cylinder arrangement once again. So the piston is freely reciprocating inside the cylinder. We have a certain quantity of the gas and we attach a heat source. So the heat is transferred from the heat source to the gas and the gas will expand because PV equal to constant. So this is how it is expanding. So when you add the heat energy, the gas will expand, that is volume is increasing. So when the volume increases, the process is called as expansion process. So when you heat, when you add the heat energy to the gas isothermally, the gas will expand. And similarly, when you reject the heat energy isothermally, the gas will be compressed. So isothermal expansion, heat addition process. Isothermal compression, heat rejection process. That is the PV diagram for the constant temperature process. Now, for isothermal process, we have PV equal to constant, which is equal to P1V1, which is equal to P2V2, which is constant. So, we can simply write PV equal to P1V1 equal to P2V2 equal to a constant for this particular process. Now, the work done. So, from the thermodynamics definition, integral PdV, work done equal to integral PdV. Here, we have two limits, V1 and V2. So, we integrate between V1 and V2, P into dV. And from the previous equation, so from this equation, we take P equal to P1V1 divided by V. So, that is what the equation, P1V1 divided by V. We substitute here for P value. So, P into dV equal to P1V1 by V into dV. Here, P1V1 is a constant, initial property, we take outside the integral. So, integrate dV by V. So, integrating dV by V, it is logarithmic of V. And substitute in the limit V1, V2. So, P1, V1 logarithmic of V2 by V1. Or this is also equal to P1, V1 logarithmic of P1 by P2. So, because from this equation, P1 by V1 equal to P2, V2. Rearrange P1 by P2 equal to V2 by V1. This is the work done for the process. And change in internal energy, the general expression is MCV into T2 minus T1. And here it is equal to 0 because T1 equal to T2. For isothermal process, T1 equal to T2. So, there is no change in the internal energy of the gas. And similarly, change in enthalpy is also equal to 0 because there is no change in the temperature for this gas. And relation between pressure and volume. So, we have P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. So, rearrange V2 by V1 equal to P1 by P2. That is what the relationship between pressure and volume. So, we completed constant volume process, constant pressure process and constant temperature process and we take the next process, adiabatic process. So, the condition for adiabatic process, there is no heat transfer between system and the surrounding. So, when there is adiabatic process, when you hear the name, immediately you have to tell there is no heat transfer between system and the surrounding. Q equal to 0 for this particular process. And when Q equal to 0, we have to derive all the other conditions. So, what is the additional condition? Because of the heat transfer equal to 0, what is the additional condition for adiabatic process? That is PV to the power gamma equal to constant. So, in the previous process, isothermal process, PV equal to constant. Now, here PV to the power gamma equal to constant. Where gamma is called as adiabatic index. And we have to derive. So, how the PV to the power gamma is equal to constant, how the condition is obtained, that we have to derive. For that, we take the first law of thermodynamics. So, we have first law of thermodynamics in differential form. So, Q equal to W plus delta U or del Q equal to du plus del W. And for adiabatic process, we know del Q equal to 0. So, the equation is du plus del W equal to 0. So, du is mcv into dt and del W equal to P into dV. So, that is what the from the thermodynamics. So, for thermodynamics, the work done equal to PdV work. And for this equation, mcv into dt plus PdV equal to 0. For unit mass, divide the equation by mass. So, cv dt plus PdV, small v, specific volume now. So, this is the total volume. And small v is the specific volume equal to 0. Now, from the perfect gas equation, PV equal to RT. PV equal to RT. Differentiate this equation. So, here remember, pressure is variable, volume is variable, temperature is variable, R is the only constant. So, differentiating, first left hand side, P dV. So pressure is constant, differentiating V dV plus V. So V is constant, differentiating pressure dP equal to here on the right hand side R is constant, differentiating T dT. So P dV plus V dP equal to R dT. So dT temperature equal to P dV plus V dP divided by R. So this is what the temperature equation, temperature term, dT term, and this dT term you have to substitute in the equation number 2. So substituting equation 3 in equation 2, CV into dT. So dT equal to PdV plus VdP divided by R plus PdV equal to 0. To take R is a common denominator. So that R, when R equal to common denominator, CV into PdV plus CV into VdP plus R. R is given, taken to the second term, R into P into dV equal to 0. So first term as it is, second term as it is, third term R is replaced by Cp minus Cv. So R equal to Cp minus Cv into PdV equal to 0. And so first term Cv into PdV plus Cv into VdP, and you, here we expand Cp into P into dV minus Cv into P into dV. So what we find, minus Cv PdV plus Cv P, sorry, plus Cv PdV. So first term and last term they are getting cancelled. So what is left out? Cv into V into dP plus Cp into P into dV equal to 0. That is what left out. Second term and the third term. Cv into V into dP plus Cp into P into dV equal to 0. Divide the equation by PV. Pressure and volume. So we'll get Cv into V dP by PV plus Cp into P dV by Cp. PV, that is equal to CV by CV into dP by P plus CP into dV by V equal to 0. And we take the last term, divide by CV throughout dP. So here, so you take divide by CV now. So the last term, you divide by CV. So dP by P plus CP by CV into dV by V equal to dP by B. The CP by CV equal to gamma. This is what known as adiabatic index. So the adiabatic index is gamma equal to Cp by Cv into dV by V equal to 0. Integrating this equation, logarithmic of P plus gamma into logarithmic of V equal to 0. So grouping, combining the two logarithmic term, logarithmic of PV to the power gamma equal to constant, and take the antilogarithm. So finally, PV to the power gamma equal to constant. So this is the condition for adiabatic process. So starting from the first law of thermodynamics, using the perfect gas equation, we derived the condition for the adiabatic process, which is PV to the power gamma equal to constant. So this derivation, this may not be useful, very much important for examination. You have to remember PV to the power gamma equal to constant. For competitive examination, you should have the analytical capability. So the analytical skill is very important to derive the PV to the power gamma equal to constant. The curve in the PV coordinate for adiabatic process follows the above equation, which is PV to the power gamma equal to constant. So for this process, PV to the power gamma equal to constant, which is equal to P1V1 to the power gamma equal to P2V2 to the power gamma equal to constant, or we can take pressure combining the, taking the first and the third term, P equal to P1V1 to the power gamma divided by V to the power gamma. Now here work done equal to integral PdV once again. So thermodynamic work done equal to integral PdV, substituting for P. So from the previous equation, substituting for P equal to P1 V1 to the power gamma divided by V to the power gamma. So P1 V1 to the power gamma is a constant. So integral V1 by V2 dV by V to the power gamma. And you integrate. So you take the V to the power gamma to the numerator. So V to the power of minus gamma into dV. So P1 V1 is a constant. V to the power minus gamma plus 1 divided by gamma minus gamma plus 1 between the limit V1 and V2, and here P1 V1 to the power gamma divided by 1 minus gamma is a constant. Substituting the limit V2 to the power 1 minus gamma minus V1 to the power 1 minus gamma. Now we have P1 V1 to the power gamma equal to P2 V2 to the power gamma. You multiply, you take the, for the numerator to the inside the bracket. So P2 V2 to the power gamma into V2 to the power 1 minus gamma minus P1 V1 to the power gamma into V1 to the power 1 minus gamma divided by 1 minus gamma. So V2 to the power gamma, V2 to the power minus gamma is getting cancelled. So what is left out? P2 V2. So we will have a P2V2 minus P1V1. I take P1V1 minus P2V2 divided by gamma minus 1. This is equal to MR into T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. So, the final equation, the work done for the adiabatic process, W equal to P1V1 minus P2V2 divided by gamma minus 1, which is also equal to MR into T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1, because P1V1 equal to MRT1 and P2V2 equal to MRT2. Now, the same equation we can further simplify. We take P1V1 outside, P1V1 by gamma minus 1, this equal to 1 minus P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, these final three equations are important. So, W equal to P1V1 minus P2V2 by gamma minus 1, which is also equal to MR into T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1, which is also equal to P1V1 by gamma minus 1 into 1 minus P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, in thermodynamics, the three final equations are important for solving the problem. And the change in internal energy, delta E equal to U2 minus U1, which is MCV into T2 minus T1. And change in enthalpy, delta H equal to H2 minus H1, which is MCP into T2 minus T1. So, change in internal energy, change in enthalpy is constant, is the same equation for all the processes. And relation between pressure, volume and temperature. So, P1 by P2 equal to V2 by V1 to the power gamma, and T2 by T1 equal to V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, or T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. The final equations are important that you have to remember. So, for solving the problem, the work done equation, change in internal energy equation, change in enthalpy equation, relationship between pressure and temperature, volume, all these equations are important. So, you have to write it down and carefully remember so that it will be useful for solving the problem. And polytropic process, so here PV to the power n, for polytropic process PV to the power n equal to constant, where n is the polytropic index. So, the derivation, calculation, everything is very much similar to the previous adiabatic process. The only difference is the gamma is replaced by n. So, we straight away take the equation, work done equal to W equal to P1V1 minus P2V2 divided by N minus 1, which is equal to MR into T1 minus T2 divided by N minus 1. W equal to P1V1 by N minus 1 into 1 minus P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N. And change in internal energy, the same equation, delta E equal to U2 minus U1, which is equal to MCV into T2 minus T1. And the change in enthalpy equal to H2 minus H1, which is MCP into T2 minus T1. And heat transfer for the polytropic process. So, Q12 equal to U1 minus U2 plus W12. So, U1 minus U2 equal to CV into T2 minus T1 plus W12 equal to R into T1 minus T2 divided by N minus 1. So, substituting, you take R into T1 minus T2 divided by N as a common term. T1 minus T2, look at here, T1 minus T2 is taken outside. So, this will be 1 minus CV into N minus 1 by R. So, just combining the first and the second term. So, R into T1 minus T2 by N minus 1, and simplifying this, so 1 minus N minus 1 by, so CV by R equal to gamma minus 1. So, finally, the heat transfer equal to gamma minus N by N minus 1 into R into T1 minus T2 by N minus 1. So, look at the derivation and take down the derivation. Sometimes they may ask the derivation. But for solving the problem, the heat transfer for the polytropic process, you can use this equation. Q12 equal to U2, change in internal energy, delta U plus W. Or you can use this equation, gamma minus N divided by N minus 1 into R into T1 minus T2 divided by N minus 1. So, this is the heat transfer for the polytropic process. And relation between pressure, volume, temperature, P1 by P2 equal to V2 by V1 to the power N. And similarly, T2 by T1 equal to V1 by V2 to the power N minus 1, and T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N. So, the derivation, it is very much similar to the adiabatic process. And now we discuss the 4-5 processes, constant volume process, constant pressure process, constant temperature process, adiabatic process and polytropic process. We combine all the processes. So horizontal line in the PV coordinate, when you have horizontal line, pressure is constant. When you have a vertical line, volume is constant, right? When you have an inclined line, right, that is PV equal to constant, PV to the power n equal to constant, or PV to the power gamma equal to constant. So look at here. So we take the general expression PV to the power n equal to 0, n equal to constant. So when substitute n equal to 0, the process becomes constant pressure process. And we take PV to the power n equal to constant. When you substitute n equal to infinity, right, we will get a constant volume process. When n equal to 1, this is isothermal process. When n equal to gamma, this is polytropic process. So we can draw the PV diagram for all the 5 processes in a single diagram. And we have one more process called a free or unrestricted expansion process. We consider the chamber, it is an insulated vessel. The vessel 1 is filled with gas with a certain pressure, and vessel 2 is completely empty, and these two vessels are connected by a valve A. So remember, vessel 1 is filled with some gas and vessel 2 is empty. So filled with some gas with the pressure P1, and the volume remains constant. Now when valve is open, the gas is expanding. So the device is completely insulated, there is no work output, there is no heat transfer, and the air is expanding and occupying the vessel 2 also, and this is called as free expansion or unrestricted expansion. Right, there is no work done, there is no heat transfer because the system is insulated. So this is free or unrestricted expansion. So when you apply the first law of thermodynamics for the initial and the final state, so Q equal to W plus delta U. For free expansion process, Q equal to 0, W equal to 0, then delta U equal to 0. So when delta U equal to 0, U1 equal to U2. So when you have perfect gas here, U1 equal to U2, that means T1 equal to T2. So for free expansion process, what is the condition? U1 equal to U2. What is U1? Internal energy before the expansion. U2 is the internal energy after the expansion. So both are equal. Internal energy before the expansion is equal to internal energy after the expansion. That is the free expansion process. And this is what the conclusion for the entire lecture. So we discussed the 5 important process, leave alone the free expansion process, all the 5 processes: constant volume process, constant pressure process, constant temperature process, adiabatic process, and polytropic process. And we have calculated work done, heat transfer, delta U, delta H. So if you look at the values, delta U, the equation for calculating delta U is the same, MCV into T2 minus T1. For all the 5 processes, MCV into T2 minus T1. So for constant temperature process, delta E equal to 0 because T1 equal to T2. And delta H, look at the delta H equation, it is MCP into T2 minus T1. For all the 5 processes, MCP into T2 minus T1, and for isothermal process, it is going to be 0. So the only difference is work done and heat transfer. So work done, look at constant volume process, there is no work done, W equal to 0. When W equal to 0, Q equal to MCV into T2 minus T1. For constant pressure process, work done equal to P into V2 minus T1. Then heat transfer equal to MCP into T2 minus T1. For constant temperature process, W and work, heat transfer, work done, they are equal, which is P1 V1 logarithmic of V2 by V1 or P1 V1 logarithmic of P1 by P2. So work done for the adiabatic process, P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by gamma minus 1, and heat transfer equal to 0. Work done for the polytropic process, P1 U1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1, and we calculate the heat transfer W plus delta U. So W plus delta U is the heat transfer. So this table, you can even prepare the table in your notebook and keep it ready for solving the problem. And these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And you can, if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. So thank you for watching, and I will meet again.